You have been waiting for that series for a super long time. Today we'll be talking about how to work with replaced ECUs on BMWs. What do I mean by replaced? For example, if something, one of the ECUs on that vehicle goes wrong and you have to replace it. Of course, if you install brand new, produced by BMW, buy it from the dealer, installed to the car, you either code or reprogram it with the ISTA or with the ECUs, no issues will occur at all. But of course, used ECUs are a bit cheaper. That's why people are choosing those. And how to work with those properly will be covered in today's series. Hi all, I'm Vladimir. You are on BeamDoc channel and you're watching ECUs for Dummies part 5. Because it's part 5, I will be not covering all the previous parts from 1 to 4. A lot of details are already shown there. For example, if you don't know how to correctly to connect to your vehicle to not have any issues during the connections, see part 1. If you have no idea what is the FA or vehicle order for a BMW, please see part 2, because without those pre-knowledge, you will be unable to understand and proceed in following video. While preparing to make that series for you, very spectacular and super useful, of course, I had to choose one of the ECUs to be replaced on my vehicle and updated. The criteria were, the first, it should be easily accessible, so it should be in the place where I can reach it really fast, not to waste half a day disassembling the vehicle. That was the first criteria. And the second one was the price of the ECU. I have chosen the SCR ECU. This is the ECU that is the part of the AdBlue system of the vehicle. Well, I have chosen it because it's located in the trunk, in the right part, rear right part of the vehicle. And also because a lot of vehicles have the issues with the AdBlue system. That's why those ECUs are really cheap at the market, because a lot of people are just reprogramming out that system and those ECUs are not needed anymore. That's why I have chosen that for our video. To make things a bit more clear, I would like to highlight that just replacing an ECU and making a retrofit are very similar procedures, and at the same time they are totally different procedures. What do I mean by that? Just replacing the ECU, for example, taking out the SCR ECU from that vehicle, replacing it with used one, and coding or programming that ECU to the vehicle is one procedure. Because that ECU is already the part of the vehicle, I don't have to make anything with the vehicle order of the vehicle. If you're making the retrofit or putting something into the vehicle that was not meant by the factory or meant to that car when it was produced, but it was introduced to other BMWs. For example, you want to retrofit the better multimedia, or for example, the MBT Evo want to retrofit over there. The procedure will be very similar to current video, but you will have to make the changes to the vehicle order. If you don't know how to make those, please see ECUs for Dummies part 2. Over there I'm talking about what is the vehicle order and how to make changes over there. So, for the video to be a bit easier for you to understand, I'm just replacing the ECU. I will not make any changes to the vehicle order, because in majority of the cases it's not needed. But if you're doing the retrofit, changes in the vehicle order are must. Without those, it will be just impossible to do. When you have made your proper vehicle order or the FA, then the procedure will be super easy. That's why the vehicle order is super critical for the BMW, and you have to understand it from what it consists and how to play with that. Let's don't waste any second. I'll just replace the ECU quickly, then we'll connect to the car with the ECUs and I'll show you all the steps what you have to do to replace broken ECU to working ECU, but working used ECU. I'll show you how to code it and how to program it. I have removed all the needed components. Actually, only that side cover had to be removed. And over there, actually, you can see our SR3 ECU. That guy over here. Now let's quickly swap the ECUs and then we'll continue with the interesting part. That's why you are here, how to software-wise to adapt it to the vehicle. Done. And establishing connection to the vehicle, exactly as I have showed you in ECUs for Dummies part 1. As you can see, we have connected the SCR ECU to the vehicle. After pressing read the ECU, you can already see it in the SVT or system variable tree. And over here you can see our SCR ECU. And actually, it should work straight away. Of course, because it's the SCR ECU and some information is written to the engine ECU as well, you have to, through the ISTA, make all the initializations to that ECU in order that to work. But that's not the video about that one. We're talking about how to replace the ECU properly and how to even program the replaced ECU. So, over here in the SCR ECU, you can see the different files, but you don't see the coding file over there. Usually, when you put used ECU to the vehicle, the coding file will be missing. And always the step number one will be to code the ECU to the vehicle. How to make that properly? Unfortunately, the SCR ECU is the type of the ECU that does not have the coding file. What do I mean by that? You cannot see the coding file here, but if we open, for example, the engine ECU, you can see the CAFT or the coding file there. It's absolutely okay. Some ECUs should not even have the coding file. That's why the SCR ECU might be not the best one for the purpose of these videos, but I'll still anyway show you what steps you have to do to code the used ECU to the vehicle. We'll just choose another ECU. For example, if the SCR ECU, you just highlight the ECU while you are in the coding tab, and over here you can see the button detect CAF for SVE. If I press that one, it will show me the error, so no mapping is possible, and so on, because that ECU should not even have the coding file. That's why it don't have to be coded to the vehicle. But if you choose another one, for example, let's choose engine ECU. Just pretend coding file is missing there. It's not there. Just pretend. You highlight the ECU, the used ECU you have just purchased from the scrapyard. You click detect CAF for the SVE. And then you select one of the coding files. Which one to select, how to go through that system correctly? Actually, I have already shown you in the video when on the G11, on the 7 series, I was replacing the headlights. That's why just go over there into that video. I have shown it somewhere there and have a look to that procedure. I'll just choose the correct one. And after that, you just expand it, right click, press code. And voila, that's done. Wasn't it easy? And exactly with the same procedure, you can code whatever ECU, used ECU, to your BMW. It will work in two cases. First, that ECU should contain coding file. Because if it should not contain, for example, as the SCR ECU or gateway ECU, there's just no need for that. And the second criteria, that coding file should match the software version inside the ECU. If you get errors, for example, the coding file cannot be chosen, then you have to update the software in the changed ECUs. Otherwise, you'll be unable to fit it to the car. Of course, guys, for those of you who are like really experts and do understand that actually you can change the database inside your computer to match the software inside the ECU, blah blah blah, and so on. Yes, it's also doable, but for majority of you, it will be easier just to update one ECU, increase the level, increase the software inside the ECU so it will match. And of course, I was showing that to you in my video about the headlights, how to retrofit those properly, not retrofit, how to exchange those properly. So if you feel at the moment you don't get how to code the used ECU, after that video, see another video about the headlights and you'll get it 100%. And the things are starting to get a bit more interesting if the coding file is not accepted, because ECUs cannot find the proper coding file for the software version inside the ECU, and you have to update it. So, because I promised you how to make the coding and the programming of the retrofitted ECU or exchanged ECU, here is how it should be done. The beginning of the procedure is exactly the same as I'm showing in my ECUs for Dummies part 4 or programming or flashing. You make all the calculations. I am explaining those steps why I'm pressing which button in great details, so feel free to see the part number 4. Otherwise, you'll be just making the same button clicks without understanding why it should be done. The thing I want to show you, the calculations the ECUs will make to the vehicle before sending the software into the vehicle. Because there is one super important part you will see about the exchanged ECUs. And actually, one life hack from my side to you guys. If you are buying the used vehicle, you can even use the ECUs for more advanced diagnostics of the vehicle. For example, with the help of ECUs, you can see which ECUs were exchanged in the car and which one were the originals. So, I'm expanding the ECU tree, and based on the calculations, you will see which ECUs are the original from the factory in that vehicle and which one were exchanged. So, how do I know that? It's based on the colors of the calculated files. You can see the HV or the hardware, HVAL or HVAP, HVAP or HVAL. If those files are with a black color, it means that ECU is from the factory in that vehicle. It was never exchanged. Or if it was exchanged, it brand new was fitted there. Usually, no one puts the brand new ECUs in their used vehicles. Everyone is using the used one, in majority of the cases. So you're just scrolling down the files, you can see, for example, the BDC, HV or hardware files are black ones, so it means it is the original ECU. The cluster, HV is the black one, so the cluster was not exchanged, and so on and so on and so on. Let's scroll down to the SCR ECU, and we need our SCR. And actually, over here, at the moment, you can see the HVL hardware is black. It should not be in the same way. Actually, the hardware should be also colored because that ECU is changed. So I guess I have to eat some salt because this is the exception in my theory. Believe me, all the cases I have seen before, if the ECU is exchanged, the hardware should be still black, the colored. And if it was colored, you cannot proceed from that step forward because your programming will fail. But no worries, I'll still show you how to make the trick, how to trick the ECUs to not make the hardware colored, and it should be black before updating the ECU. And here's the trick. Guys, this is offline record making during the post-processing of the video. Actually, I'm learning with you as well. Have a look to that picture. You can see the SCR2 ECU. You can see the two software files. The blue one, as you know, it's the one that is currently in the vehicle. And the red one is the one that we're going to be deployed from the computer to the ECU. And have a closer look. You can see that the blue one, so the one that is in the vehicle, it is from the G20. And actually, I am working with the G30, that's why the G30 software have to be sent into that ECU. So based on those calculations, you can still see that ECU was exchanged. And you will be not able to see that after the flashing of the current ECU. So this is a very important remark. I guess the hardware is still black because I have purchased the ECU that is number to number exactly the same one as the one in my vehicle. That could be the case. If it was a bit different, then we will see the picture I wanted to show you. But guys, my apologies. Yes, we can still continue with that video. So, if the hardware is not black, but it's colored, so the trick is, over here in the ECUs, you can see the button HVID from the SVT actual. You press it, ECUs makes the recalculation, and then you open the ECU that was retrofitted, in our case, the SCR ECU, and then the hardware will turn black.
After that, you continue exactly as I have shown you in the ECUs for Dummies part 4, and you will be able to successfully update that ECU, update the software inside that. So let's make the procedure until the end.
And if you are still unable to make the hardware black and still remains colored, you have to play with the I-step shipment in that field marked by the red circle over there. It means you have to match that criteria to the production date of the ECU you are putting into the vehicle. Just look at the label. If the production date is written there, it will help you a lot. If nothing is written, you just have to play with that until hardware will be black. Only then you can continue.
One more interesting thing. Obviously, you thought, hey, Vladimir, how should they know if that ECU should contain coding file or should not contain coding file? After making those calculations for software update, you can see that parameter, the CD deploy. It is meaning coding data deploy inside the ECU. You can see on some ECU it is grayed out, for example, the gateway, as I told you, and the SCR ECU, it is grayed out. It means that that ECU should not even have the coding file. This is one of the ways how we can understand which ECUs should contain coding file and which ECUs should not contain. So I have made all the calculations. If I was a bit too fast for you, ECUs for Dummies part 4, over there I'm explaining in great details. Let's press start and update that retrofitted, not that retrofitted, but exchanged ECU. And successfully updated. Nothing hard, as I promised you. You can even go back to coding tab. I always prefer to go back to coding tab after programming whatever ECUs. And at the beginning we have seen 32 ECUs. Let's press read ECU. And we still see 32. So it means we have connection to all the ECUs in the car.
In today's video, I have shown you how to code or program whatever ECU, okay, almost whatever ECU to your vehicle. Wasn't it super easy? Of course it was. And you were asking for a video for such a long time, and because it was like so easy, I just didn't get the point why you need that information, because it's so easy. But maybe it's easy if you know the answer. And now, actually guys, you know the answer. And of course, if you are still not subscribed to my channel and you do enjoy the things and that I'm showing to you, feel free to subscribe to the channel. Of course, leave the comments about the possible future topics that should be showed on my channel, because actually the best video ideas are coming from you guys. So if you are not active in the comments, I just cannot get you what information do you really need to know. For example, that video, I believe it will be super useful, and actually it is super easy. See you next time. Bye.